to my kitchen. Did you know that the seeds of okra can be dried and brewed as a substitute for coffee? Yes, that's right. It's known as okra coffee. That said, however, today we will use the vegetable to make okra masala. This vegetable is popularly known as lady's finger. Let's get started with the preparation. For this, I'm using 250 grams of lady's finger. Firstly, I soaked the okra in water for an hour with some rock salt in it. Later, I wiped it with a clean cloth and cut it into 1-inch pieces and set it aside. Here goes the ingredients: tomatoes 2, onion 1, ginger garlic paste 1/2 teaspoon, green chilies 2, cumin seeds 1/4 teaspoon, red chili 1, turmeric powder 1/4 teaspoon, red chili powder 1/4 teaspoon, coriander powder 1/2 teaspoon, Kashmiri chili powder 1/2 teaspoon, kasuri methi 1/2 teaspoon, garam masala 1/6 teaspoon, coriander leaves 1 small ball, oil approximately 2.5 tablespoon, and salt to taste. I'm going to heat a wide bottomed pan along with 2 tablespoons of oil. Once the oil is hot, I'm adding in the cut okra pieces into it and give a half fry. Going to remove the half fried okra pieces and set it aside. Now goes the balance oil into it along with the cumin seeds to splatter. Adding the chopped dry chili and the sliced onion and give it a fry. Add in 1/2 teaspoon salt. Adding in the ginger garlic paste and fry nicely till the onion turns golden brown. Now it's time to add in the powdered masalas one by one, beginning with turmeric powder, red chili powder, and give a good mix. Coriander powder, Kashmiri red chili powder, all the masalas have fried well, I'm going to add in the chopped tomatoes and fry well till its raw smell leaves. Roughly chopped green chilies. Now I'll add the kasuri methi into the mixture and mix well. I'm going to add in the half fried okra into the mixture and give a gentle mix. Adding in half of a small sized bowl of water into the mixture so that the okra absorbs the masala flavor. Leave the lid half open and cook for about 4 to 5 minutes on a medium heat. Almost done. Now I'm adding in the garam masala powder into it and mix it. Now is the turn to add in our last ingredient, the coriander leaves, and mix gently. It's done, and now turn off the flame. Look, all the okra pieces are in right shape, none of them have broken or opened up. I'm going to serve the dish in a bowl and garnish it with coriander leaves. This dish is awesome in taste. Try out this recipe at home and leave a comment below. I would love to hear of your experience. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. Thank you for sparing your valuable time. I'll see you soon with a new recipe. Until then, stay safe, stay blessed. May God bless you.